안녕하세요 여러분. 저는 미국에서 온 션입니다. So I'm here today with someone that I really admire, Son Hyun-woo, and he speaks English very well. A lot of people think though that you have to live abroad to really learn English well, to speak fluently. But have you ever lived abroad?
Nope.
Really?
No.
Are you sure?
I am sure.
Okay.
Okay, so my name is Hyun-woo, Son Hyun-woo, and I am from Gwangju, 전라도 Gwangju, from South Korea. And like I've learned English here in Korea without living abroad. I don't think it's a bad thing to necessarily like study abroad, but I believe you can learn any language without living in a country where it's spoken as, you know, people's native language.
인정. I totally agree. Do you remember what life was like before knowing English? How did you feel when you saw a foreigner?
So the first time I saw a foreign person was when I was in high school, and wow. I was scared. Well, I think it was mainly because I had only seen like foreign looking people on TV and in books, and they were mostly white. I didn't, you know, really have a concept, you know, in my head.
Everybody learns English in Korea from a young age, but what made you get serious about really improving your English?
I was considered to be bad at English by many people. I also wanted to enter this specific high school.
Yeah.
I took a test for it, but I failed. And one of the main reasons was that my English score wasn't high enough. So I wasn't considered to be good at English at all. And also the test score just made it official.
Yeah.
So I felt frustrated, and I didn't really like the feeling that I had back then. So I didn't want to be stuck in this state. I wanted to overcome that situation.
Yeah, I totally understand.
I had been, of course, taking classes in middle school, but then as soon as I entered high school, I really, really, really started like learning to speak this language.
You speak very well now, but how long do you think it took for you to be able to speak this well? How long?
So I think it's a very slow and gradual linear process.
Okay.
But I think it took me about 2 years before I could freely converse with people.
Express yourself,
yeah, so I obviously didn't know all the words I needed, but I could talk around the
words.
If I didn't know the word for 냉장고, which is a refrigerator, I would say, you know, the big white box where you put food to chill the food. So, and then people would get, you know, they will get the idea, oh, you mean a refrigerator. You know, the moving staircase, escalator, and I will know the word. So until I reached the point where I could talk around a more difficult word, I think it took about two years.
What other languages do you speak now? Because I know you like language.
So English is my strongest language, of course, after Korean. My Korean is much better than my English,
okay,
obviously. And also I speak Japanese and French.
Okay.
And I can understand quite a bit of Spanish and Chinese.
Wow!
If you could give the most simple, easy tip for people learning English right now, what would that be? Something that they can do today.
Keep a journal. Because once you start keeping a journal, like a daily journal, where you write down everything you did that day, everything that, you know, that came to your mind, and start writing, you realize how much you don't know.
Yeah.
How to express certain things in that language.
Yeah.
So, oh, what did I do? I bought this. How do I say buy in English?
Yeah.
And you write that down.
That's right.
But then you bought it. You know, you did it in the past tense.
Uh-huh.
Oh, what's the past tense for buy? You look it up. Suddenly you have this urge to express things. So find things that you want to express in English, and then start from there.
Do you want to say anything else about your business that people can look you up at?
I do have a personal YouTube channel at youtube.com/everfor1.
Yeah.
And I also run a business, which you are you know, visiting right now. Talk to Me in Korean is a YouTube channel where we teach Korean, the Korean language, in English.
Yeah.
So maybe if you check out our channel, Talk to Me in Korean, maybe you will also find it useful for your English learning efforts.
Bingo. Thank you so much for watching, everybody. And please subscribe if you haven't already. See you next time.
Bye-bye.
Bye.